We love Metal Gear Solid. We love Snake. We love his moustache. We love MGS4 despite all its faults. In fact, sometimes we love it because of its faults, because we love the impossible, ridiculous force that is Metal Gear. MGS4 is a fantastic send-off for a series that always revelled in its own barmy, saucy adventures. Even if you took all of Hideo Kojima's brilliant indulgences away and stripped it to its core, it'd still be one of the best series around. If you need proof of that, just look at how addictive the VR missions were in the older games. And one of the unifying, reliable features we love about the Metal Gear saga the most is its bosses. Endlessly creative, brilliantly cinematic, sometimes even breaking the fourth wall, MGS bosses are truly special. Apart from one case of the boss ball being dropped in pathetic fashion, Crying Wolf. It's hard to describe the disappointment of Crying Wolf because all the ingredients seem to point to another brilliant fight. An epic cinematic location that has importance in the MGS storyline, and a robot with a railgun and a Swedish model inside. But also manages something that no other MGS fight ever did. It's boring. I don't know what it is about it. Maybe the arena's just too big, maybe the weather effects, although pretty, just get in the way. Maybe it's the army of helpers. Something that no other boss has ever needed, just annoy me too much. But every time I get to this boss in a playthrough, it just takes me forever and I turn it off because I get bored. I fixed the problem by keeping a save file from just after the fight ready in my PlayStation, so that as soon as I get to the boss again, I can just load it up, pretend I did it, and carry on living a lie.
Did you like it?
Sorry, Kojima. No, I didn't.